So, with Tai Chi, you're aware of tiny, tiny subtleties, but they have to be within the gross movements. So, a warm-up or a basic training I like to do for our Guang Ping Yang long form is the stances of half horse. You can start horse, half horse, bow and arrow, so you should feel your calf stretch, and turn in on the heel. So this is a hard movement for a lot of people. Shift the weight slightly forward, create negative space, and rotate your whole side on of your whole rear side. Right? If you do the ball of foot, it is like a stretch. It's more a stretch. It's not a martial way to move. So on the heel, and then lift the front toe, lift the back heel, twist the waist to the high lotus. Spin back around, toe and heel. That'll get you back to your original horse, which could go either way, right? But now we're going to alternate to the other side. Half horse, and try to stretch your upper inner thighs here. So this is a liver channel, strengthening the quads, pivoting on the other heel. So take that whole leg and then rotate it. Okay? And stretch the back. You're going to feel your calf stretch. Don't leave your butt behind. Get your butt under your head. Slightly lift the front toe. Lift the back heel. Stretch your foot. Twist the waist. That's high lotus. Spin back, left toe, right heel, or opposite if you're looking at the video. Now we'll add one more movement. So we're going horse, add horse, bow and arrow, high lotus, back to high tiger. Pull to the other side. You can do middle of the low tiger if your legs are open. And we'll go on the other side. You can feel your legs start to engage now. Horse, half horse, bow and arrow, high lotus, and high tiger. Okay, now let's talk about the macro movements in the hand. So our Tai Chi palm, the thumb doesn't stick out. It's contiguous with the fingers. It's really a strike with this little bone on the edge, but because it's Tai Chi, everything's a push and not a strike, because you're trying to not kill your training partner. So, and it's done slowly. Well, now when you see the hand leading with the fingertips, what's going on there is that the fingertips in martially what's going on. Well, let's talk about the Tai Chi aspect first. I mean, the peaceful part is that you're seeking to uproot rather than to demolish. So you're going under your partner's center of mass and lifting them out of there, peeling them off of gravity, so to speak. Also, what you're doing is that you're going under the belly of the muscle with your fingertips and then slamming again. These hard areas, striking surfaces, it doesn't hurt you, it hurts them. Under the belly of the muscle, which is protecting these points that really hurt when you get hit in them. Okay, so you're going under the belly of the muscle, banging the palms. All right, now let's talk about the hook. So there are a lot of different ways that you see people doing Tai Chi hook. I've seen people just bend it and have their thumb sticking out. When I learned praying mantis, the hook was more like that. The dill, as Brendan used to call it. Like a dill pickle, it sounded like. Anyway, you've heard of this movement where you're striking with the back of the wrist, so it kind of justify someone fighting in front and fighting in back when they lift that higher. But in our form, and I like the wrists to be the same height, right? The chest to be open, we have a very broad form. The fingers to be pulled back slightly, so there is some tension. The elbows under, and think about the center of the palm, the Lao Gong point is a big energy center. And the other thing that I really prefer is to touch the nail beds to each other. Touch the thumb to the finger pads, and then stretch the wrist down. So you have a yin side pointing to earth, a yang side pointing to heaven in it. It very much, so we practice the form on both sides, so you get a very balanced feeling from that. And it's pretty tricky. So there's a lot going on in the nail beds. That's the, if you look at acupuncture charts, you'll see lung, large intestine, pericardium, a heart, you know, so you're connecting your meridians when you do that. Okay? So there's a lot going on energetically and martially with the hands. Okay, that's your video du jour. What do you want to do? You get to call it. Chest. Let's try 10 each way. Beginning with the pinkies. Jerry comes to privates on purpose.
But she was crying the last one.
She was so frustrated just with that first door movement. Okay, now we're going to go the other way. Lead with the thumbs. Well, it's interesting. So you notice you can flip the palms front and back or on the sides. You know what I mean? That's good. Keep doing what you're doing. Very nice. Okay, let's switch it. Just like